Welcome, learners. I, Dr. Anshu Mathur, welcomes you all to the NIOS studio at the course number 509. Today, we are going to learn about curriculum of history at elementary level. The more you know about the past, the better prepared you are for the future. Theodore Roosevelt rightly said this for the need and importance of the history. When we talk about need and importance of the curriculum of history at elementary level, we need to know we are living in a country where history and its culture was the major part of its development. When we talk about need and importance of the history, we should know we live in the country where the past and culture was the major part of its development. The NCERT has laid down the following objectives of elementary education. They said to acquire the tools for formal learning, namely literacy, numeracy, and manual skills. Secondly, to acquire the base habits of cooperative behaviors within the family, school, and community. Thirdly, to develop social responsibility by including habits. And lastly, to appreciate the culture and lifestyle of a person of other religions, regions, and countries. Because we live in a country where the diversity is the main character of our society. Now, we talk about the need of history at elementary level. A study of the present in the light of the past is an essential part of any growing. History is the study of man. History is concerned with man in time. History is concerned with man in space. Objective record of happenings. History is a dialogue between the events of the past and emerging futures and not only narration but also analysis. History continuity and coherence are the necessary requisite of history. History is relevant and comprehensive. Thus, we need to teach history at elementary level. When we talk about the value of teaching history at elementary level, we should know the growing age of children, that is 7 to 14 years. That time, we need to tell everything about our country, about our past, to grow the aesthetic values and the moral values among our children. The values of teaching history at elementary level can be divided like this. Primary value, inculcate the values of creative thinking and critical thinking among children. Informative values, no doubt provides the information about our past and to roadmap of a future. Cultural and social values provides children to know about the culture and heritage of India and the world and the value of social norms and morals. Political values provides them the events, major leaders, great men of Indian and world history, and they value and or then they can be a role model of the children for the future prospects. Nationalistic value provides children to maintain the nationalism, patriotism, and develop a sense of belongingness towards their nations. Internationalistic values, no doubt, provide children a global citizenship and to provide them the brotherhood, a feeling of belongingness, and the feeling of interrelationship with other countries and continents. Educational value provides an insight about the development and the past and give the students a chance to learn about the history and the society, their interaction through the education. Intellectual values provide student a knowledge about past and creates an intellect about right decision, justification, equality and equity, which is the essence of the modern world. Ethical values provide children to learn from the past and to grow better human being for becoming a better and responsible citizen. Vocational value provided by history is uncountable. History is a vast subject which provides too much of general knowledge to crack all the sincere and senior examinations, and to have a vocation in history, archaeology, museum and whatnot. When we discuss about the aims of teaching history at elementary level, we come to know that history is to promote self-understanding. It is to give proper conception of time, space and society. It provides students to enable the pupils to access the values and achievements of their own age. It is to teach tolerance and it is to develop right attitude among children. It is to foster national feelings. It is to develop international understanding. It is to teach moral principle. History is to help resolve our contemporary social and individual problems as well. History to promote socialization among people. Thus, the history at elementary level is an essential part of education and cannot be replaced by any other subject. There are objectives to foster in children an interest in the past and to develop an understanding that enables them to enjoy all that history has to offer. History offers them to enable children to know about significant events in history and to appreciate how things have changed over time, how we have developed, how we have reached so far, to have some knowledge and understanding of historical development in the wider world. They came to know about the world and their position at globe, to help children understand society and their place within it so that they develop sense of their cultural heritage. They should value that, and it is the heritage which has come from generation to generation and will pass on to develop the children the skills of inquiry, investigation, analysis, evaluation and presentation so that they could be a better professionals in future. History in the beginning level helps to enhance the social understanding of students. We teach festivals of India, different types of families, clothes we wear, food we eat, our country, state of India, my country, socio-religious structures, etc. That is helpful children to connect with the surroundings, that helps them to grow with the surroundings, that helps them to appreciate their surroundings. It helps students to observe, learn and understand human behavior, value and aptitude and their interrelationship which exist among different people. They come to know about the different religions and cultures which exist in the world other than their own. They also learn about the societal strata and norms of society and the need of various governing bodies, other institutions as well. History makes a significant contribution to develop a child's knowledge and understanding of the world through activities such as dressing in the historical costumes, looking at pictures of famous people and history. They also value these great people during their studies. They learn how to inculcate those habits in their moral development, and history helps them to develop as all-around man. The basics of history curriculum at elementary level can be listed like this. It offers to develop an interest in and curiosity about the past. It teaches to make the child aware of the lives of women, men and children in the past and how people and events have had an impact upon each other, to develop an understanding of the concept of change and continuity. It provides to the acquisition of concepts and skills associated with sequence, time and chronology appropriate to the development stage of the child, to allow the child to encounter and use a range of historical evidences systematically and critically. Offers to foster sensitivity to the impact of conservation and change within local and wider environments. It helps the child recognize and examine the influence of the past on the attitudes and behavior of people today. It is to foster a willingness to explore personal attitude and values and to promote an openness to the possibility of changing one's own point of view. It is to encourage the child to recognize how past and present action, events and materials may become historically significant. It is to enable the child to acquire a balanced appreciation of culture and historical inheritance from local, national and global context. Teaching and learning style of history at elementary level should include focuses on imbibing children to think as historians. It should enable children to think critically. It should place an emphasis on examining historical artifacts and primary sources. It should develop interest in the surroundings and value them. It should recognize and value the importance of stories in history. And we should regard this an important way of stimulating interest in the past. It should focus on helping children understand that historical events can be interpreted in different ways and that they should always ask searching questions such as how do we know about the introduction they are given, about the information they are given, and about the event, about the people. We should equip children to evaluate evidences and arguments to develop perspective and judgment. It is not always right to be online. It is always right to have multiple aspects of an event. Curricular aspects at primary level can be contribution of great men in different fields of life, stories about heroes of war and prophets of peace, men of letters and pioneers of science, saints and sages, artists and patriotics, etc. They can be glimpses into the social conditions and elements of daily social life of ancient times. It could be value of daily work, social life, culture, society of ordinary people, make them aware the change in the orders of things with the progress of time. Class 1 can be introduced with such kind of information, like the student should be introduced to the following facts at this stage: local traditions, stories relating to local social workers, saint, religious places, historical places, local fairs, etc. Apart from this, stories of the ancient men, stories about food, utensils, tools, ways of living on the caveman and the people of Stone Age and the Copper Age. Then practical work can be of visit of a local place like museum, etc., and making clay models of historical utensils, toys and tools. We can teach children at second level, second class, the local traditions and the stories about ancient culture. For example, a broad view of the local traditions taught in class 1, stories about Babylon, Mohenjo-daro, Acropolis, pyramids, etc. Life, the pupils in ashrams and its comparison with Chinese, Greek and Roman life, practical work as in the first grade beside preparation in models, coins of clay and the album of historical pictures should be done at this age to inculcate all the values of past. Class 3 student can be exposed to the story of ancient India, for example, Ram, Krishna, Buddha, Mahavir, Alexander, Ashoka, Kanishka, Chandragupta, Vikramaditya, etc. These stories are to be presented in a chronological order. Practical work pupils should be helped to understand distance and directions and initiated in map drawing. They should be taught how to make an album of historical pictures, dramatize events and do craft work. At the class 4th level, stories from medieval India, example, Prophet Muhammad, Muslim invasions on India, Prithviraj, Alauddin Khilji, Firoz Tughlaq, Chaitanya, Nanak, Kabir, Krishna, Krishna Dev Rai, Akbar, Chand Bibi, Maharana Pratap, Aurangzeb, Shivaji, Bajirao and Bajirao II, etc. Practical work could be as in class 3, children album should contain pictures of art and architecture of the Mughal period. It will surely help them to grow and inculcate the value of aesthetic sense in the Indian society and culture. At the level class 5, students can be told stories from modern India, Clive, Mir Qasim, Tipu Sultan, Nana Farnaseev, Rajneet Singh, Jhansi Ki Rani, martyrs of First War of Independence, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, etc., Vivekanand, Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Patel, to know the legacy of India and to value their contribution in Indian history and the modern India. Now we will talk about the teaching at elementary level. What it needs is to learn about how and what children want. What are the objectives and aims were defined to teach history? They were all about to know and the value, history and past, culture of India, society, democracy and our morals. We can teach history by telling them different kind of stories. I can put an example for you. That is, if you are teaching a Stone Age, you can create a model a storyboard for them, and you can tell them how and which kind of tools they were using. We can ask a student to make those tools by clay, or they can find stones from the playground, and they will know how the Stone Age people were living their life, leading their life without any amenities around surrounding them. This is how we can teach with innovative ideas and ask them to collect pictures, tools, make tools, providing them by the essential items available at that time. Now we will talk about the value of history teaching. A broad and balanced understanding of history is essential if a child is to become a confident, informed, critical, and responsible adult member of society. It can help the child to understand more fully the world in which he/she lives, how events and personalities have shaped the home, location, and wider environments in which he is and she exist. At the same time, the curriculum provides for the exploration of various aspects of history through which the child will become aware of the individual groups, events, cultures, beliefs, and values, and the past and shaped contemporary society. History is also concerned with the influence of the past on the present. History should allow the child to explore how the actions and experience of people in the past have influenced subsequent generations. While teaching the elementary level children, we should always remember this, that history can be, say, like a story about the past in different ways. It does not mean that one version is right and other is wrong. Children should initiate the thinking and should come up with ideas of people and events. People in the past did not always think the same thing were as important in their lives as we do today. Lastly, we need to tell a clear story. We need to choose which bits to use and the means deciding what is important. We should connect children from past and now to make them for the better future. Thank you very much.